story tells the unbelievable true story when three young African-American men were murdered at the Algiers Motel during the Detroit riots in 1967. Now I was really looking forward to seeing this movie. We're getting to that part of the year where all these award-nominated movies are going to be coming out soon, and this film did not disappoint. I really liked a whole lot about this movie. For one, the acting across the board is really good. There wasn't a performance in this movie that I didn't like. John Krasinski, who's best known for Jim out of The Office, is in this film for very little, but even he had a really solid performance in this film. Obviously, I'm a Star Wars fan. I was really looking forward to seeing John Boyega in this film. Not a whole lot of him, but what he gave me in this film was really good, especially in the latter part of this movie. He's doing a lot of subtle things with this movie, and he doesn't say a whole lot in this film. A lot of his performance is reacting and trying to stay within his own boundaries of the character, and his character just doesn't want to overstep his bounds, because if he does, he's going to get like wrapped up in this whole event in the wrong type of situation. I mean, and I don't want to spoil anything, but the way his character goes about, he's trying to help out the people in the situation, but he doesn't want to overstep his bounds and have the white cops turn on him in this film. And this entire time, you're just waiting for him to do something to help everyone in this situation. But again, he just doesn't want to go too far out of his own like jurisdiction, if you might say that, because he's a security guard. I don't think he has a jurisdiction, but you can tell throughout the entire film, Boyega does all these subtle things and all these small reactions that I ate up his entire performance. Will Poulter has a really good performance in this as well. He's just so good as the lead antagonist in this film, and he just gets under your skin. You just can't not hate this character, and that's just has to do a lot with the performance that he gave. And across the board, such good acting in this film. I also really enjoyed the writing in this film. The events that happened in this film, I mean, I wasn't born at this time, and I hardly ever knew anything about the Detroit riots. So to go into this film and see these events unfold, it hit you so hard. And just imagining that things like this actually happen, even in these days today, it was just the events that unfold and the way that the screenplay played out, it makes you really reflect on things that happen even today. And it's just, I'm not going to get all political on this. It's so terrifying to imagine things like this happening in the world that we live in. And when movies like this happen, they're based off true events. You're kind of like wondering like how much is dramatized and how much is actual facts. But like, I don't know, this film just hit me so hard. I just really like the drama and the conflict of this film. Now, not only just with the characters of the white cops and the black civilians, but I also like the inner conflicts within the characters. And again, John Boyega's character is conflicted because, you know, he wants to stay true to his job and not overstep his bounds, but also try to help out the people in the situation. But also, the movie gives you enough time to be attached to some of the characters and see how they handle situations and what like inner conflicts they go through as the events unfold. One of the character arcs that I really enjoyed was Aldi Smith as Larry. I mean, he just to see where he starts off in the movie and then how he ends up at the end, just his arc, I really enjoyed how this event affected him personally. You see the struggles he goes through and like how he has an opportunity presented to him at the end of this film, but he stands so strong in his beliefs and what he went through in this film, and he goes off in another direction. I just really appreciated that the film showed you that. Then it's not just like this is what happened and then just leave that. It shows you what the characters go through and what they lose and something else that they gain. I really enjoyed that part about it. And also, another thing that I really, really thought that the film did very well was show you both sides of the story. And like, and one of the films that comes to mind is Straight Outta Compton. One of my gripes about that film was that the portrayal of cops is that every single cop in the entire movie was a douchebag. And you hated every single cop about that. And I just didn't like that portrayal because, yeah, in the times, it seems like all the cops were really, really big shitty dirtbags, but there are some good cops. I'm coming from somebody that has friends and family in law enforcement. I really appreciated that you got to see like, yeah, there's these three main like dirty cops in this movie, but then the movie goes out of the way to show you that not all cops are like that. And it wasn't only with the cops as well. You saw the other side of, you know, the black youth in this film, but that this whole event could have been, you know, avoided if one particular thing just didn't happen and that one character just didn't go that far. The cinematography in this film is also something to be appreciated too. I like the almost documentary style of filmmaking in this movie. There's a lot of handheld shots, a lot of shaky cam, and it makes you feel that you're right there with the characters as the scenes play out. There's very few stable shots in this film. It's a lot of like punches in and punching out. The camera actions felt very like reactive rather than planned out, and I really appreciated that part about it because, again, it makes you feel like you're there. But I will say, at times I was kind of over a whole shaky cam, especially when you're chasing a character through like a back alley and stuff, and the camera was just all over the place, and I did get a small headache in those scenes, and that's my only gripe about the cinematography. But overall, the cinematography in this film should be appreciated, and it made you feel that more connected to the characters and that more connected to the story. But as much as I enjoyed the characters and the storytelling and the cinematography in this movie, there's one big glaring problem that sort of hurts it for me, and that this movie is just, it's too long. I felt like maybe 20 to 25 minutes could easily have been shaved off of this film, and I would have had more satisfying runtime had it been around close to 2 hours and 5 minutes. No more than that, I feel, would have, you've been able to tell this complete story within that time frame. But there's this whole sequence that's before the movie, is this animatic sequence that just felt really out of place. And I thought it was like a commercial at first, but then it's like, oh, okay, we're watching the movie. Great, cool. Giving you the whole history leading up to the riots. And I just felt that was kind of unnecessary because when you look at this movie and like the meat of the story, the movie's really about what happens at the Algiers and not about the riots. It just happens to be an event that happened during the riots. And I really think they could have just sort of like, you know, not ignored, but like giving you just small little bits of like news clips and text to show you like this is where we're at during American history and this is what's going on. Just give you that much information so you have enough context to see what's going on, but then lead you into the real meat of the story. And then the whole ending kind of does drag on a bit more. I feel like had they just shaved off like 10 minutes in the beginning and 10 minutes in the end and just sort of tightened up those parts of the film, I feel that it would have been better paced out and more, just a more satisfying running time. So overall, this was a terrifying yet powerful movie to see. All the actors across the board had really good performances. There's not a single performance that I didn't like in this film. I like how the cinematography makes you feel like you're in the middle of the situation, in the middle of the riots. But again, I felt this movie was just too long. That runtime really dragged. But overall, I enjoyed this film. So I'm giving Detroit 4 out of 5 stars. So go ahead and comment below, tell me what you thought of Detroit if you saw it. If you like this review, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button and check out some of my other reviews on this channel. To stay up to date on all those videos, hit the subscribe button right there. Thanks as always for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.